I chair the Senate Committee on Judiciary. To my right is Senator Hoylman, who is the ranker of Judiciary. We're joined by many of our distinguished Judiciary Senators, and let me start by introducing them. I start with Senator Bailey, Senator Kaminsky, Senator Boyle, Senator Serino, Senator DeLon, Senator Phillips, my good friend Senator Lanza, Senator O'Mara, Senator Breslin, Senator Amador, Senator Hamilton, Senator Stavisky, and Senator Kavanaugh. All right? So let me get started. We welcome the judges today and their family members that are here. We're going to consider Governor Cuomo's reappointment of 10 judges to the Court of Claims. I'd like to thank the governor for putting forth an impressive list of nominees for the court. The experienced jurists that are here today have all been approved by the Judicial Nominating Commission. We always strive to put judges on the bench who display exemplary temperament and dedication to the bench. And I'm confident the nominees before the Senate Judiciary Committee today will hold themselves to such standards. During this meeting, I'll call each judge to come up and sit in that chair, and it's not a hot seat, and provide the committee with a brief introduction and submit to the committee any questions or comments about the judge, and any senator can ask any question about the nominee. So let me start with Ellen Bibbin. Judge Bibbin resides in New York. She was appointed to the Court of Claims in 2015 and is currently serving in the Supreme Court criminal term in the First District. She has taught a course on government ethics at New York University School of Law as an adjunct professor since 2013. And last year, Judge Bibbin was honored as an outstanding woman of the legal profession by the New York County Lawyers Association. So, would any senator like to speak on the nominee? All right, hearing none. Senator Kaminsky.
Yes, I just want to say that the community of former prosecutors, as well as those who appear in front of Judge Bibbin, only have excellent things to say about her temperament, the way she moves her docket, and overall just being an excellent judge. So I enthusiastically support this renomination.
Thank you, Senator Kaminsky. Anybody else here? Do I have a motion to confirm? Senator Kaminsky, move the nomination. Do I have a second? Everybody in favor? Nobody opposed? Judge Bibbin, you're in. Okay. Yeah. Congratulations. Just so you know, this is preliminary. The big one is on the Okay, our second judge is Glenn Bruning. Is Glenn here? Have a seat, Glenn. Judge Bruning resides in Queensbury, New York. He began serving the Court of Claims in 2011 and is currently an active Supreme Court Justice in the 4th Judicial District with a civil caseload in Essex, Warren, and Washington counties. He previously served as assistant counsel to Governor Cuomo, Patterson, and Pataki on environmental issues. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Okay. Senator Breslin.
Judge Bruning has a great reputation, and it's evidenced by the fact that he served for three governors. I remember chatting with him about it some years ago. Three governors, two of whom were Democrats and one were Republicans, and if all three were able or not to be here, they would all say positive things, and I think he's done an exemplary job in his years as a judge.
Thank you, Senator Breslin. Anyone else? Okay. What I'm going to do is we will move the nomination till the end, and we'll move all the judges. All right, we'll save some time. Judge, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Our next one is Judge Cohen. He resides in Stony Brook. He was appointed to the Court of Claims in 2006 and is currently sitting as the supervising judge for the felony criminal term in the 10th Judicial District. Previously, Judge Cohen spent 25 years in the Suffolk County DA's office. Since 1993, he's been an adjunct professor at Toro Law Center and has been awarded Best Adjunct Professor twice by the Student Bar Association. Eddie. Senator Boyle?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'd just like to say that I've known his honor for many years, 30 years. He's a wonderful prosecutor in Suffolk County. I've known him since I actually applied for a job out of law school at the Suffolk County District Attorney's Office. I did not get the job, but I still support him.
Thank you, Senator. So, Judge Cohen, what did you enjoy more, being a judge or being a professor?
I think I like both.
Oh, good answer, Judge. All right. Thank you, Judge. We're going to go to the next thing. We'll move this. Next is Judge Judith Hard. Judge Hard resides in Albany, New York. She served on the New York Court of Claims since 2002 and currently presides over Article 78 actions. Previously, Judge Hard was the Executive Deputy Commissioner of the New York State Department of Tax and Finance and was responsible for the management of the department and 5,500 employees. Additionally, she has worked with both the Assembly and Assembly as Legislative Counsel to the Minority Leader and the State Senate as a Legislative Analyst. And I would say I first met Judge Hard as a minority member in the Assembly under Clarence Rappelier. She was awesome then, and she continues to be awesome today. So, does anyone want to speak on this nominee? I see she lives in Senator Breslin's district. Does anyone else want to speak on this? If Senator Breslin, yes.
Well, Judge Hard went to the bench, and having many people, including my good friend David Roos, say extraordinarily beautiful things and complimentary things about you, and you've continued to show that he was right in this analysis.
Thank you.
Anyone else wishes to speak? Judge Hart, thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right, the next is Judge Albert Lorenzo. Good Irishman. Judge Lorenzo resides in Armonk, New York. He was appointed to the Court of Claims in 2002 and has served both in the Bronx and Westchester counties. He previously was an assistant dean for career services at St. John's University School of Law and attained the highest percentage of graduate employment in school history with over 99% of the 2001 graduating class employed within 9 months of graduation. Earlier in his career, Judge Lorenzo was an assistant DA and conducted over 25 jury trials. Does anyone like to speak on this nominee? Hearing none, what is fascinating to me when I read these brief resumes, how talented you individuals are in many aspects, whether you're a professor, whether you're an administrator, whether you're a former judge, whether you're a prosecutor, you've worn many hats in your journey to this day. A very talented group. All right, I think, Your Honor, we're finished with you, and I thank you for being here.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Judge Lorenzo. Judge Roger McDonough. Judge McDonough resides in our backyard in Delmar, New York. He was appointed to the Court of Claims in 2006 and is currently an acting Supreme Court Justice, resides over civil and criminal matters in the 3rd Judicial District. Prior to becoming a judge, he was the senior assistant counsel to Governor Pataki and focused on criminal justice legislation. While attending the University of Maryland School of Law, Judge McDonough was a two-time recipient of the American Jurisprudence Prize. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Senator Breslin.
Judge McDonough resides in Del Mar, our hometown, and enjoys a reputation that somewhat frightens me as being somewhat more conservative than my younger brother Tom in criminal cases. And so continue the good work, Judge. Good to see you.
Thank you, Senator.
Judge, yes, Senator Hoylman.
I just wanted to know that you have seven children, so Godspeed.
They wanted to be here today, Senator, but there wasn't enough seating.
Thanks, Senator.
Thank you, Your Honor. Next is Judge Juan Mershon. I hope I pronounced that correctly. And Judge Mershon resides in Freeport, New York. He was appointed to Court of Claims in 2009 and has served as an acting justice of the Supreme Court in New York County criminal term since his appointment. Additionally, he was invited to establish and preside over the first mental health court in the history of New York County, which launched in January 2011. Previously, Judge Mershon served in both the New York State Office of the Attorney General and the New York County District Attorney's Office. Does any senator like to speak on this nominee? Senator Lanza.
Thank you. Mr. Chairman, first I want to commend the governor on this entire slate of appointments. As you said, very, very impressive. It was my privilege to work with Judge Mershon a few moons ago in Manhattan District Attorney's Office. And I can tell you all on this committee that he truly distinguished himself as a prosecutor and trial attorney, and he's done so equally on the bench. He really is everything you would ever want and expect from someone serving on the bench. He's an excellent jurist, but perhaps more important than that, he's just a good, decent person of the highest integrity. And it's my pleasure to, my pleasure to support him and his family. Good to see you, Judge.
Thank you, Senator Lance. Anyone else wish to speak? Hearing none. Thank you, Your Honor.
Thank you.
Senator Judge John Mikulski.
It works, yes.
You got a first one with the bow tie. Looks good.
Thank you.
Judge Mikulski resides in Williamsville, New York. He served on the Court of Claims since 2006 over a mixed caseload of both civil and criminal matters. Previously, he was a partner at Schneider and Mikulski for 15 years, where he focused on criminal and civil litigation, business formation and advice, estate planning, and real estate matters. Additionally, he has been an adjunct professor at Medial College since 2008. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Senator Jacobs.
Thank you very much, Judge. It's great to have you here. I've known Judge Mikulski for quite some time. Even when he's wearing a t-shirt, he wears a bow tie. But as a county clerk in Erie County, we worked a great deal with his office. It was a pleasure to work with you. And also as county clerk, I always hear complaints or compliments of judges, and only compliments for the work he has done. So congratulations.
Thank you, Senator.
Thank you, Senator Jacobs. Anyone else?
I would.
Yes.
I would just like to say, Your Honor, how are you?
Well, sir.
We spent about a month of our lives together many years ago in a courtroom in Olean. Mm-hmm. We had a lot of fun representing co-defendants. He did a great job then, and I fully support your nomination here
today.
Good
to see you, sir.
Good to see you.
Anyone else? Hearing none, I want to thank you, Your Honor, and then we're going to go to the next one.
Thank you.
Judge Robert Schwartz. Judge Schwartz resides in Fort Salonga, New York. He served on the Court of Claims since 2015 as an acting justice of the felony trial courts of the Supreme Courts of both Queens and Nassau counties. Prior to this, he worked in the Appeals Bureau of the Nassau County DA's office for 25 years. Would any senator like to speak on this nominee? Okay, hearing none, I don't want you to be disappointed. Congratulations, and we're gonna move to the next judge.
Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Thank you,
Your Honor. Last but not least is Judge Maxwell Wiley. Judge Wiley resides in New York, New York. He was appointed to the Court of Claims in 2003 and has been an acting justice in the Supreme Court in New York County since 2004. Previously, he worked for the New York County District Attorney's Office for 17 years. Would any senator like to speak on the nominee?
Yeah, I guess I'll go ahead.
Senator Kavanaugh, would you like to speak?
Yeah, the judge is a constituent of the 26th Senate, although we haven't had the opportunity to interact. We're very proud to have some sort of distinguished constituent here today, and I look forward to working with you.
Thank you, Senator.
Thank you, Senator Kavanaugh. Anyone else wishes to speak?
Yeah, I would just like to speak in support of this, this nomination. I worked under Judge Wiley in the New York County District Attorney's Office in Trial Bureau 50, and I only have one question for you.
Yes.
How did Warren Murray let you go?
Warren's still in the office.
I'm sure he is. I put out. Yeah. It's good
and
to see you.
And you have to change a bit, Senator. Thank you so much.
At this time, excuse me, Senator Lanson.
Well, I just want to say I still have Warren Murray's sheet on the grand jury presentation.
Yes.
all of you in Trial Bureau 50 are famous for it. Over in Trial Bureau 70, a few of them made it over to Delaware.
I'll talk to Mr. Murray when I see him. Thank you. It's good to see you. Thank you, Senator.
Any other senator wishing to speak? Hearing none, I now would like to move the nomination of all 10 Court of Claim judges for reappointment. Second by Senator Hoylman. All in favor?
Aye.
Unanimous. All right. We're going to now close the meeting. It's 10 after 3. And we will now take this up on the floor, hopefully within a reasonable time. Okay? Thank you.